Hi, welcome to this question right here. So we're trying to figure out the possible k that can go in here. So we're doing the trinomial factoring. So if you remember that in order to figure this out, there's a bracket to start off, and you put an x here. Now, the number that goes here and here is basically this. You need to figure out the factors of 8 first. So two numbers, that two numbers that will give you the 8. What do we have? We got 8 and 1, right? So we got 8 times 1. We also have 2 times the 4. Okay? So if you put 8 and 1 here, they have to give you a negative 8. So one of them has to be a negative. So it could be negative 8 or 8 negative 1, right? So those are two possible choices that will give you the negative 8 if you multiply them together. Now, if you add them together, you get yourself a possible of, this will be a negative 7, and this will be a 7. And that's what that k will represent, okay? We're not here trying to figure this out. We're here trying to figure out the possible case. So for the first k that we have plus minus 7, okay? Now, on the other side, we got 4 and 2 to try it, right? Or 2 and 4. Now, 4 times 2 does give me 8, right? But one of them has to be a negative. So it could be negative 2 and 4, or 2 and negative 4, okay? Now, if you add them together, okay, it's either we got a 4 minus 2, which is going to be a 2, or a 2 minus 4, which is going to be a negative 2, right? So those are your possible k that will go right in there, okay? So more k's we have, we got plus minus 2, and those are your 4 possibilities, okay? Thanks for watching.